Hello, 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 everybody. I am Rhymes with Mash, and I am joined in the commentator's booth by none other than Shed. How are you doing?
Hey, what's up, guys?
I'm doing all right. How are you?
I'm pretty good. Looking forward to this Dynascapes Intermediate Cup Round of 32 match. We're back at it. We have Team HTT at Seed 8 versus Osu Freaky at Seed 25. What do you think about this matchup?
Oh yeah, it's another high versus low seed matchup, but I think HTT is gonna sweep. Any of the bottom 8 seeds didn't seem to perform very well on any of the qualifier maps, so we'll see.
Hey, that's the statistical prediction, but hey, we saw earlier that in another one of the high versus low seeds, it wasn't a sweep. It was a 4v1. I can't remember which teams it was, but I'm always going to root for the underdog. I think Osu Freaky, they're my dogs. I think they got a chance.
We'll see. I'm going to pull up the qualifier stats real quick.
Always a good idea. Something I noticed looking at those is that Osu Freaky actually outperformed HTT on two of the Rice qualifiers, Rice 2 and Rice 3. So I think we can expect them to definitely be playing the Rice side of the pool, and then HTT definitely going for the LN side, as they performed really well on LN1, LN2, and Hybrid 1.
Yeah, I'm glossing over the stat sheet right here, and HTT definitely performed way better on the Rice picks than the likes of Osu Freaky.
At least on Rice 1, yeah, they seeded 6th on Rice 1, whereas Osu Freaky placed 24th. So if I were in Osu Freaky's position, I would definitely avoid Rice 1 in this pool, the jump stream pick. But I think the tech picks and maybe something like Rice 4, Rice 5, maybe they could be open for a point for Osu Freaky, because they got 15th and 18th, whereas HTT got 19th and 20th.
Yeah, that's a little rough spot. Get a nice little LN warm up here. And fail. Nice. And another fail. Nice. Good lord. Already a great start to the match. When you have the players failing the warm-ups.
Curious. I don't know what exactly is going on. Oh, it's because we didn't play with no fail on. That's important to not fail, you know?
Yeah, right. HTT actually performed very well on Hybrid, the Cranberry City, and the LN1 pick for qualifiers. So we'll look to, I think they might play similar maps, given that the map pool probably has options, kind of like that.
Yeah, they seem to be well-versed in the sort of release-y LNs that we see in the likes of LN1 and kind of Hybrid 2 in this pick, or in this pool, rather. I think they'll definitely protect LN1 if it's not banned. As for Osu Freaky, I don't know. Maybe they might protect Rice 3, Rice 4. It's hard to say. Their options are definitely a lot more limited than HTT.
Right. Osu Freaky actually performed the worst out of the qualifying teams on LN2, which is the fancy thing. Definitely hoping Rice 1 gets played again. It's my favorite map.
That's a good one, yeah. I don't know which one I like the most. I think I really like Hybrid 2 in this pool.
It's good too. I like. I'm a Rice player, so any Rice map is gonna outdo a Hybrid or an LN map.
That's fair enough. I think we've seen which pick was it? It was... Oh, I don't have the pool open. One moment. Main spreadsheet. I'm a bad commentator. Should have had this up.
You're good.
We've seen LN3 picked a lot. That's what it was. The oral cigarette song, Fantasy.
Yeah.
Which is kind of surprising. Usually for tournaments like this, with this demographic, we usually see the LN picks avoided a lot, but we have seen that with LN1. People do not want to play releases.
Yeah, right. LN3 is just such of a long map that I didn't expect teams to be playing it that much.
That too, yeah.
Because if we look at the map pool, your round of 32 LNs are 2 minutes, 1 minute, 2 minutes, 1 second, and then 5 minutes, and LN3 is almost 4 minutes long.
Yeah, that LN2 is so short. And we've seen that one picked a decent amount as well, which is kind of funny.
Right.
Client seems to be struggling. It does not like when players fail, even if they're using no fail.
Right. And, oh.
Bancho's working overtime.
Right. Looking at Hookseye, Hookseye is doing okay for a map of this level with the density and all that stuff.
Yeah, this is a Bandusty map. Does not really hold back on these long notes. I'm not sure whose warm-up this was, but it's pretty evident that Osu Freaky is not trying.
I think they wanted to skip warm-ups.
Yeah.
And there goes Client.
That's all right. It's over, I think.
Oh, an error has occurred. Oh, boy.
I love this this technical difficulty screen. Shout out Normiplier. Greatest GFX artist ever.
Oh, we're back. Are we back?
We may be. I believe we're going into Osu Freaky's warm-up. I'm hearing frums.
I do hear frums. And it is frums. The mid-pack.
I love Wave Tapper.
Oh, is this an SV? This has got to be SV.
I'm pretty sure it is.
Because there's no team is going to pick a 2.5-star map as a warm-up and have it not be SV. This just also sounds like an SV map.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see. Sight reading SV, yep, we're right.
Yep.
Tapper.
I don't think I've ever actually seen this map. I've heard of it, for sure.
Oh, geez.
But I've never played it.
Oh, geez. This already looks tough. Entry definitely doing a lot better than the rest of the pack.
Yeah, it's pretty evident who picked this one.
Right. Still finds a miss eventually. Good lord. This just hurts my brain.
It's great, isn't it?
Yeah. 61,000 is the score difference, and it's growing rapidly. Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
if the team I was playing in a tournament picked this as the warm up, I would be pretty angry. I just wouldn't play.
Yeah, honestly.
Especially in a tournament like this where there's no value in picking an SV when there's no SV to pick in the match.
It's a classic troll. The stupid hard SV warm up.
I had a match a few hours ago that their warm up was a map that one of their teammates made, and it was like 40.5 stars, and it was
bad. Was it a Timor Leste by chance?
Yes, that was Timor Leste.
Yeah, I know exactly who you're talking about. Cyger is kind Cyger. Of known for that. Even clients having trouble with this map.
Oh, got some substantial combo now, but it's not gonna matter. Look at all those graphs.
That's a Tycho graph, dude.
That's my Osu Mania graph after the rework.
True. And hey, we're getting into the rolls. Looks like Hooksai is pulling out a 46. Entry's getting a 41. I believe that's Team HTT winning the roll and getting to choose whether they get to ban or protect first.
HTT, let's see it. Aren't protects always first? Oh no.
They seem to misunderstand the rules a bit. When you win the roll, you get to say protect either they protect, you protect, they protect, or they protect, you protect, and then the bans happen. It's easy to make that mistake if you're one who does not read the forum post. Whoops. Yes, as our amazing referee, a case 100 notes, roll winner always gets to pick first.
Yup. They're gonna definitely protect first. Oh, okay, never mind. God.
Lost the perception check.
Yeah, I did. So, Osu Freaky is actually gonna win this match 4-0.
This is true. I know it to be true. So, we're going to see what Osu Freaky's going to protect. My money's on Rice 3. We'll see who wins.
He's going to pull like Hybrid 2 out of his ass or something.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Rice 4.
Rice 4.
The rare ballistic rice map. I'm thinking HTT is going to protect Long Note 1. I think that's an easy choice.
Yeah, definitely. Unless they go with, like, LN3. That's
yeah. Yeah. That could be it. And they're going with Hybrid 2, okay.
Hybrid 2, okay.
I think they're just flexing that they have so many options in this pool. HTT gets their ban.
HTT's gonna ban.
I'm thinking the ban Rice 3. That's my choice.
Rice 3 is just such an easy map to take a point off of somebody. But because it's easy, that means the other team has a little bit of a chance as well.
Yeah, yeah. Love Lab, Race 2. That makes sense.
That makes sense, because that map's tough.
It is speedy.
especially with some of the patterns evident in there.
Mm-hmm. Osu Freaky gets their ban. If they don't ban LN1, yeah, there it is.
There it is. LN1 is banned.
Poor Ballistic. Always getting that net banned. But HTT's going into their first pick. Who knows what they're going to go with. I wouldn't be surprised if they just pick their Protect off rip. It's always a good strategy.
Right. HTT. Let's see. Rice 4.
Okay.
That's their Protect, isn't it? Or is it the
other team's Protect? Yeah, that's
Is it the
other team's Protect? Yeah.
Wow.
The power move. All right.
Statement move.
And do not be fooled by the blue outline. The picks are flipped. This is HTT's pick, not Osu Freaky's. There you go.
Oh.
Thank you, Sun Apple.
There we go.
Shout out Sun Apple, our scream team.
I didn't even know that was a thing. Oh, all right. Getting this map. Let's do it.
Yeah, Rice 4. This is a pretty fun map. It's really short, less than 2 minutes. But it is somewhat techy, and it has some denser bursts, some heavier-handed layering. So you should definitely look out for that. Stay on your toes a little bit. It's definitely a contrast to Rice 3, which is a whole different flavor of tech, the kind of slippery tech that you need to really lock in for.
Right. Lord. Slower pace than any of the other matches I've been a part of in the booth.
Yeah.
Oh, never mind.
People still getting a feel for the the multi-client. Yeah, that's what this tournament's for, you know? You gotta get that experience.
Good ol' Osu. Alright, launching right into this one.
Here we go, first map.
My stream. Oh, no, we're good. Damn, this dude. It's flickering already.
Yeah, first couple bursts right out of the gate. Both teams are holding on pretty strong. Hooksai notably in the lead with a 99.9-ish. Osu Freaky, more consistent within their team, and Ty lagging behind the rest of the lobby at a 99.7, which is still really high, all things considered.
That consistency is something that could very well win Osu Freaky this match.
For sure. If Hooksai were to choke...
And you just stuck it into
existence. Oh my god.
Oh man.
I apologize for the commentator's curse.
Gotta love the commentator's curse. I knew it was gonna happen.
About halfway through the map. Yeah, that scoreboard immediately flicked to the blue side. Hooksai took a lot of damage with that miss. And Osu Freaky holding strong, consistent.
Osu Freaky is looking to win their Protect, but they didn't pick it.
Yeah, getting a break point will really show them who's boss on this power move.
Just not enough time to come back here for HTT, as they will drop this first point, barring a disaster.
Yeah, Osu Freaky, both players outperforming both players on HTT. But look at Hooksive. If it weren't for that miss, that'd be a really, really strong score, especially considering the ratio.
That miss comes with those 200, that 200 and that 100, relatively dirty. That's what did him in.
Yeah, but look at the only Sonic, a 990 with one grade. That's also very, very strong. Entry also with one grade. That's a really, really good team score.
Especially in the early stages when you're going against a team that you think is way superior to yours.
And for sure. Do that.
Osu Freaky is going to take their pick now.
Yeah, getting a break point in a first to four match.
I like this team already. Let's go.
Going for Rice 1. And yeah, I definitely think this is a... I don't know. This is a curious pick for them. Going against Hooksai, who's known for their high accuracy on straightforward stuff like jump stream.
Very straightforward.
I don't know. I think this is kind of a mispick, if I'm being completely honest. I think they would have better chances with something like Rice 3 or maybe Rice 5. Just because they're less straightforward and a little more techy, and they just want a tech pick, so I don't know. I guess they're feeling confident after that and hoping to go up 2-0 and build that momentum.
This map does have some rolls that have potential for misses, so maybe that's their thought process, that Hooksai might, unless Hooksai's not playing this map. Okay,
Hooksai's taken out, substituted for I Like T, and you're totally right with those rolls. That's definitely one of the trickiest parts of this map, the double roll wall. It's really easy to miss, or at least pick up a couple 200s on those.
Right.
We'll see how they handle it.
Ooh, already early miss from Ty. Two early misses. Oh, man.
Yeah, dropping down into the 98 range. Whereas, looking at Osu Freaky's accuracy, they're both super high in the sky, 99.8 and 99.9. However, I Like T is at least canceling one of them out with a 99.8, dropping little as I say that.
That's just so unfortunate. So many things can go wrong during the stages of a tournament like this.
Mm-hmm. Ty's easily recovering from those misses, gaining back to a 99.4-ish, but they're left in a deficit of about 11,000 points. So they've got their work cut out for them in the second half of the map.
I know I've dealt with keyboard malfunctions, client lag, all that stuff.
Yeah, could be a lot of things.
I Like T and Entry and the only Sonic are identical. It's just the two misses from Ty that's really making this match so super easy to win here. We'll see how they fare during the later half of this map, which is more demanding than the opening section. Seeing a couple 200s being dropped across the board from all players. The lead is slowly but surely shrinking. Will it be enough time to get Ty back up there?
Yeah, only about an eighth of the map left. We got one more chorus. I think they need a miss from Osu Freaky to win this point.
wrap up this map, it's looking less likely to happen here. And Osu Freaky is gonna win. Oh no! And will it be enough time?
Wow. Last minute miss. Thankfully, only in the last 100 combo. Wow. Look at some of those scores. Great. 2 991s. And I like T actually top scoring the lobby.
It's a great switch in from HTT, but just not enough in this point of view. How do we think HTT is gonna... How does HTT react to this?
They have to pick long note, right?
Right.
They cannot stay in the rice. They've been out-ratioed both times. So I'm thinking LN3, Hybrid 2, something like that, that really focuses on the long note side of things. I'd be really surprised if they don't.
LN2 here.
That's true. They have shown a tendency to kind of choke. Oh, and Hybrid 2, yeah. Okay. I was thinking maybe they could go with LN2, like you said, because it's a shorter map, and so less time to choke, I guess. But Hybrid 2 is also a good pick for them.
I like this pick here from HTT. Try and get one point on the board to get back into things. Carry that momentum.
They have to break the momentum from Osu Freaky, or else they can get to match point here.
Right. And in these earlier stages, the matches are shorter, so less time to cook something up.
Mm-hmm. Could we be seeing a huge upset? Seed 25 versus Seed 8 would be significant, to say the least.
A couple of months ago, I was in this position as the 8 versus the 25 in Meow Mania. I think we got swept by Russian MWC players. It was not a very good showing.
Something I took note of when I was playing this map is that there are some really fast 175 BPM mini jacks near the start. Nice. It's really easy to get some bad judgments on those. And then past that, I think this map is about the transitions between the rice and the long note sections. Here we go with some of the mini jacks. Yeah.
I played all the rice maps because I'm a rice player.
I like T. On the rice section, those straightforward streams. Really? Not sure what threw him off there, but we go into the more hybrid section.
Oh, and another miss from I Like T on another rice section.
Yeah, that's hurting, but those are really clean. I Like T still maintaining a 99.6. Canceling out entry if it weren't for those misses. And Hooksai well above both players on Osu Freaky with a 99.9.
It's just those misses, man.
Yeah. You would not think they'd be losing by 11,000.
On those LN releases. Getting a little more LN into this. Another great from entry. Another one. All eyes on that scoreboard. It's flickering, and it's not going to be enough. Another breakpoint for Osu Freaky here. We got 2v1 double S's on the side of HTT. It's just those two misses from I Like T.
Yeah, they got completely combo gamed.
92 PF from Hooks Eye.
That's insane. More than having everybody else's ratios. DDP.
Good lord.
Now OstuFreaky has the privilege of being at match point and it being their pick. And it seems like they can go pretty much anywhere they want. I would still stay away from the LNs if I were them, though.
It'd be really funny if they picked Rice 3 here and won that.
I think that's a great choice for them right now, honestly.
They've got all the confidence in the world, and if they execute like they have been on Rice 3 and win that, it's a huge red flag for the teams that they're going to end up facing in the future.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think they could go with... Oh, they're going with Rice 5.
Interesting.
I think this is also a good pick for them. Some more Jackie pick, right? And with some of the bursts that we kind of saw in Rice 4, they've shown they can have strong ratio and strong control over stuff like that. So I think it's perfectly fine for them to pick this.
Yep.
Here we go into the fourth and potentially final pick. We got I Like T and Hookside coming in again for HTT. And OstuFreaky staying with the lineup they've had for every other pick.
Like every other start of the map, it's going to flicker back and forth for a little bit.
Yeah, but HTT is pulling ahead with a mild lead of about 3,000 points. Actually, yeah, they do have a very significant accuracy advantage. Both players at a high 99.
Now, bringing this back with both of these accuracies like this, is I think it's going to be the key for HTT to come back and win this match.
Yeah, the problem is, if they win this, where do they go next? I'm not sure they would have the confidence to go anywhere other than the long notes, which is not enough for them to win the match.
If the ratio goes right, I think they could take a chance with Rice 3 and hope that the MA on OstuFreaky side is not good enough.
That's true. They're doing really well with this pick. Ratioing the heck out of these jacks.
Now, none of these players are doing particularly bad, it's just one team is simply outperforming the other by a slim margin.
For sure, they're all in the range of 990-ing this pick. HTT is locked in.
HTT. As we wrap up this map, HTT is going to take this point, and we will go on.
Wow. Look at that team score. Oh my gosh. That's absurd. 2 995s.
That's incredible. I played all these Rice maps. My score on this was, let's see, This is race four, right?
This is race five.
Five. My fault. My score on this was... I got a 998 on this, but that's why I'm skill banned from this thing.
Like you said, the other team wasn't doing bad at all. It's just, what do you do against two 995s like that?
Right. LN2.
LN2. Hooksai is warmed up now.
I like it.
TV size map. This one is somewhat more hybrid-y than the other LN picks. It's more about like, I guess, the physical element. Oh, it looks like they meant to pick LN3.
So are they just going to continue to play LN2?
I don't know.
Can I re-pick?
It's up to the discretion of the referee, I think.
Heads or tails.
He's leaving it up to a coin flip. Oh my god.
Welcome to DIC, baby.
Is that a head or is it a tail?
That's a head. Alright, you did it. Oh my god!
That's pretty funny.
And LN3. Here we go.
This is the first step to HTT's reverse sweep run.
Oh boy.
Coming back from 3-0, I believe.
It's tough.
Yeah, for sure. It's an uphill battle, but if Hooksai is truly warmed up now, as he says, maybe they can pull it off.
Mm. Well, they wanted to find out. Underway. Here we go.
Mm-hmm. 4 minutes of LN action. This is a trickier LN map. It's got, like I've said a million times before, it's got these tricky jacks, shields, reverse shields, and staggered releases. You gotta manage it all. You cannot sleep on this pick, and it's gonna drain your mental stamina all the way through. You cannot let yourself release early or late on those staggered releases, because that will kill your score throughout this map.
Both players on Osu Freaky initially struggling with this. I know I just saw an entry drop one or two 200s.
Yeah. HTT pulling ahead just like they did last pick with a small but not insignificant advantage.
Right. It's about 5,000 and growing.
Yeah, Entropy's gonna have to pull their accuracy back up if they want to get through the rest of this pick.
Oh, and another. $6,000 now. As we get into a trickier part of this map. The only Sonic is actually keeping pace with I Like T, but it's just Entry struggling a little bit on these.
Yeah, and Hooksai, the star of the show so far, 99.87. That's pretty insane on a map like this.
Now, if we pull up the stat sheet here. Hooksai. Really?
Yeah, looking at their qualifiers, go ahead.
On the LN picks, on LN1, which is release, Hook's Eye was second, and on the LN2, they placed 11th.
They are definitely a early game player. That's not to say they can't do late, mid or late game, but early game is definitely where they pull ahead of everybody else. We have the break. Osufriki can now see the scores and see that they are in fact losing the pick so far. Maybe that'll give them the motivation to pull up their accuracy.
Oh, it looks like had a miss.
Yeah. I didn't see those.
Unless they're just flying. I don't know. Oh,
another miss from entry.
I didn't actually see those either. That's interesting.
Yeah, but the lead is still growing.
I swear we went into the break and they all were still holding.
You got Mandela affected.
I did. Another break from entry. Believe it now is approaching 30,000 points.
Yeah, really significant win from HTT coming in here. And I'm believing in the tiebreaker.
So it's totally possible. They literally just got saved by a coin flip.
Potentially, yeah.
Almost V1 double S from a Hook's Eye.
Wow.
One real miss going into the break. Looks like entry just struggled there.
Yeah, it's definitely a tricky map, but again, another great team score from HTT. But now it is Osufriki's turn to pick, and this is where they can finish things off. And do not be fooled, LN2 has not been picked. Yeah, now things are correct, and I think Osufriki should definitely go with Rice 3 in my eyes. Right. Yeah. You could make a case for Hybrid 1, but I'm not going to be convinced.
Now, I like T. I just looked into their stats, and their top score was a 10th place finish on Rice 1 with the 994k.
Interesting.
That's interesting.
And yeah, there it is, Rice 3. We haven't really seen anything like this map so far. It is, like I said earlier, very slippery. So many graces and flams, and a couple jacks in the layering as well, just there to throw you off.
All right. As HTT continues to claw their way back, will this be another step in the road to the elusive tiebreaker? Definitely hoping for it. Haven't seen one yet.
The first match of the tournament was actually a tiebreaker match.
Right. But I've not been in the booth for it. That's what I meant, yeah.
Here we go. Make or break for HTT.
I like T starting off with phenomenal accuracy, staying up in that 999.
Yeah, but everybody else is close behind. Everybody in the 99.8 range. Tiniest of leads for HTT.
Let's This is actually neck and neck.
For sure. Everybody's fallen a little bit, but ILEC-T is still just that tiniest bit ahead of everybody. And that's what's giving HTT their 1,000 point lead, but it could flick over at any minute.
Dude, it's close.
It's so close.
Uxai is just falling just a little bit more behind now.
Yeah.
Oh man. This is actually gonna be close. Good lord.
Nearing the halfway point. It's been like this for like almost a full 2 minutes.
The lead is just ever so slightly kept to Team Red side. HTT, yeah. The ILEC-T show, after mentioning him, or mentioning them, just... It's just... Oh, and the lead's growing just a little bit.
Just a tiny bit. Something's gotta give. We can't stay like this the whole song, right?
There's no way. I think Hooksai is just getting it up. Just, oh! I just saw someone. Wow.
Yeah, as like you said, as Hooksai has recovered a little bit, Osufreaky has maintained the 99.79. So they do have that tiny, tiny accuracy advantage.
3,000 points now, as Hooksai and ILEC-T now have identical accuracies.
Mm-hmm.
Once again, just from ILEC-T! No way.
Oh, and it switches. Oh, but it's flickering at the very last few seconds. They gotta hold on.
No way.
It's still flickering. They can
another
claw it back
to the wire.
Oh,
and it's
no!
Osufreaky
by 2,023 points.
Wow.
V1 double S is on the bottom half. ILEC-T with a V1 double S, but with the miss.
Oh,
entry
no.
Not far behind with a 990. Everybody performed really well, but that one miss, brutal.
No tiebreaker today. I get it. I get it.
Hey, what did I say? Don't call it early. HTT did not sweep by any means.
They almost got swept.
That's true. Congratulations, Osufreaky, for winning with a very exciting ending. And commiserations to HTT going down into loser's bracket early. As a seed 8 team, they will surely do well there.
Wow. What a match. It's a shame that Walmart could not be here to witness that.
Seems like Osufreaky. Not sure who, what team that is that they're going against. Oh, it's just you. I thought you was an acronym, but it is just you. And HTT is going against Skibidi Ryokai Tenkai. Ryoki Tenkai.
It makes sense that the Czech team won. All of their scores have just been really well.
Yeah, and next up, in just 2 hours, we will be seeing Indomie versus Fortnite Lollic Club. Do you have anything left to say before we end it off?
I actually don't.
Alright, then thank you all for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Yes, we will.